let me just give you the overview of what we have discussed till now, and then we'll proceed towards the next topic. So we started off with the basics of SAP HANA, like in-memory computing and the column-based data storage and all the HANA concepts. Then we talked about SAP S/4HANA, in which we understood the key pillars of SAP S/4. And we also understood the SAP Activate methodology from the new implementation point of view. And we discussed how it is different compared to the SAP methodology that we were following till now. And in our last session, we just had a first look at the SAP system, okay, in which we seen how exactly are you going to check which version of SAP you are using and how it is different than the traditional ECC system. For example, we have seen some of the SAP Fiori screens, how to configure your own launchpad, how to add a particular app in your launchpad, how to delete something, how you can change the theme of SAP Fiori. So some of the basics about SAP Fiori we had seen in our last week. And the transaction levels, like how to create a purchase order, how to do the GRN, all these things we'll be seeing once we talk about that scenario. So whenever we'll be talking about the procurement to pay cycle, we'll be seeing how to do the transactions related to procure to pay from SAP Fiori screen. So for now, we need to start, because whatever we have done till now, it was all the things which were from the fundamental point of view to understand what exactly SAP S/4HANA is. So now let's start one by one. So we'll be talking about the, first of all, we need to talk about the master data. So what has been changed for the material master and what has been changed from the customer, vendor and business partner master data. So that is something which we need to discuss today. But before that, before we create the master data, before we go to the configuration, as I told you, we are going to create our own company code setup so that you should be able to clarify that there is no change as far as the enterprise structure is configured. So normally we go with the copying of the standard company code, but what I'll follow is it will not take more than 15-20 minutes. I will just start from scratch. So I'll create a company code, a purchase of, sales of, plant, which we will be using throughout this course. Okay, so that is all the idea that we are going to see today. Before that, I think let me give you some time to clarify your doubts if you have any related to the previous sessions, because I think Arijit has some questions before I start. Please go ahead, Arijit.
Hey, yes, hi Gaurav. Actually, I had missed two three sessions before. I had gone through the recordings.
Arijit, your voice is not clear.
Okay, you are able to hear me?
Yes, it is better now.
Okay, actually, I had missed a few sessions previously.
Recordings. Okay.
Okay. So, I mean, you know, for example, you were talking about
that Arijit, Arijit, your voice is not very clear. Can you just write your question on the chat screen? Otherwise, I think there is some problem with your mic.
Okay. I'll write your question.
Yeah. Okay. Anybody else has any question before we start?
Gaurav, this is Raghu. This is my first question again. Some questions here. So, sorry if they have been answered before. I went through recordings, not all of them, but I did go through two of them. Not the last one, the previous one. Quickly. So in this session, we are going to cover S4 SD1, S4 LG1, and S4 MA1. Is that right?
Yes. So procurement, sales and distribution, and manufacturing.
Okay. And so, for example, I know you're going to start the master data part. So we are going to see examples of how to create a... Yes, hello?
Yes, Raghu, is it fine if we continue with today's session? Because I'm expecting the questions related to the last session, but if you have the questions related to course or something, it will be good if we, I'll give you the time after the course, after the session is completed, then we can have the discussion, because there are a lot of guys who are...
Makes sense. Yes, sure, no problem. Yep, sorry.
Go on. Okay. Any question related to the previous session, who attended the session, any particular thing that they want to clarify? For the guys who has not joined the earlier sessions, I'll give you the time after this session. Okay, so let me just start with today's session, and as I told you, I'll definitely give you the time to clarify your doubts later on. So as I told you in the last session, that the screen, if you see, it looks similar to what you were able to see in ECC, right? Because you are getting two options here. The one option is using the traditional GUI, which is exactly same as you were using earlier. You will be using your user ID and password to connect to the server. And other thing is, you can directly go via SAP Fiori, which is this one, which will take you to the new GUI, which is for SAP Fiori. Okay, so from the transaction point of view, most of the users will be using SAP Fiori screens because they are simple to use. It will allow you to save the time. On the other hand, from the configuration point of view, because all the configurations are available on SAP Fiori as of today, we will still continue to go with SPRO screen. So from on-premise edition point of view, the configurations are still not available on Fiori. From cloud edition point of view, there are already some apps which are provided which can help you to do the basic configuration, but again, not fully. So you definitely need SPRO screen in both the cases, even if you are working on premise or you are working on cloud. So I'll start with SPRO. Okay. Definitely within this, and I don't mean that everything is same. There will be a lot of new things that you'll be able to see. Like for example, you can see migration to SAP S/4HANA Finance, which is definitely not going to be available in ECC, right? So there are some new things, but it is similar. The screen is similar of SPRO. I'll go to enterprise structure. As I told you, I'll create everything from scratch. It will just take 10-15 minutes, but once it is created, this will be used for our entire course. So first of all, I need to create a company code. I'll do this faster because I think this is very much, you are already aware of all these things. So let me just go fast. So for our purpose, let's say I will create a company code with code SL, which is Simple Logistics, or SAP S/4HANA Logistics. Let's say 20, I think is not used, or maybe 02. So SL02 is the company code that we created for our purpose. This is nothing but a sample company code. Okay, city I will just use as Bangalore, for example. Country IN, currency INR, and language EN. Okay, I'll just enter the mandatory information. So country is required. So this is the TR. I will just say the default TR. So the company code is now created. Next, I will go for I'll not do all this because these are not mandatory. As I told you, I'll always follow the mandatory one. Let's go for logistics and go for the plant. We definitely need a plant to perform all our transactions. So this is again SL02. Factory calendar, let's keep it as IN and save this. Again, the mandatory information, which is IN. Okay, so now we have a plant. We have a company code. Let's go for location and division. SL02, SL02. Same thing again. Division. I think SL is already being used, so I'll do this S2. So logistics general done. Let's go for sales and distribution. Create a sales organization. SL02, SL02, and save. Distribution channel, I'll again create with S2 because it is two digits. You can always copy, that is not a problem. If you want your practice, you can copy any of the company code, or all the setup will be copied automatically. So this is sales office, next is sales group. let's go to MM. We need the storage location, SL02. I'll create a same, sorry, storage location with same name, that is SL02, and save. Purchasing org. Okay, so this is done from the definition point of view. There is one more thing in logistics execution. We need a shipping point, which we need to use while creating the sales order. Okay, so from definition point of view, we are done. Now let's go for assignment. So within assignment, let's assign the plant to company code. So SL02 will be assigned to SL02. This is not required. We can come out. Sales organization to company code. So SL02 again. Save. Distribution channel. Sorry, it is not there, I think. We need to click on new entries. So SL02 will be assigned to S2. Division to sales. Same thing, SL02 with S2. Sales area, which is a combination of sales org, distribution channel and division. Assigning sales office to sales area. Finally, the sales group. Sorry, one more. Sales organization to distribution to plant. So S02, which is a distribution channel, and the plant is again SL02. Okay, so this is done from the sales point of view now. Now let's go back to materials management, assign the purchase organization to company code first and to plant then. SL02 is assigned to SL02. To plant. Okay, and the last one, within logistics execution, we need to assign shipping point to plant. So let me just select shipping point SL02, which I'll be assigning to SL02. Okay, so we are now done with the basic organization structure from logistics point of view, but as we know that this is not sufficient. Because whenever you do transaction, any material movement transaction, you need to have accounting in place. So from accounting point of view, we are still not done with the complete thing. So at least we need to maintain the global parameters, for which I will go to financial accounting global settings. Within this, there are global parameters, enter global parameters, which is OBY6 screen. Okay, so this is a change mode. I'll just try to find my company code here. And I'll just maintain the basic information like chart of account. I'm going to use the standard chart of account INT. Fiscal year variant, let's use V3, which we normally use in India, that is April to March. Field status variant, again, I'm using the standard one, 0001, and also the posting period variant. So this is the basic information that we need. All other information is not really required for our scenarios. So let's click on save. Okay, And last thing, the controlling. So within controlling, I need to create a controlling area, which I'll be assigning to my company code. So maintain the controlling area from here. New controlling area, which is going to be SL02. Company code to controlling area setting is 1:1. Currency type, there will be only one option, that is 10. Just select that. You will get this information by default coming from the company code. So SL02, it will ask for this particular thing. What is this? It is saying the cost center standard hierarchy SL02, which we provided here, is not available by default. Whether you want to create it, you'll be saying yes. So it will be created in the background. Yes. Okay. Then we need to assign this controlling area, which we just created, to our company code, SL02. And lastly, you need to go to this activate components, new entry, from year 2017. Just activate this component called as cost center. Nothing else, just click on save. Okay, so whenever you will be practicing on this server, you can refer to whatever we discussed till now, so that once this is configured, then only you will be able to perform the transactions. Otherwise, you cannot directly do the transactions in MM and SD. Okay, so this is a basic configuration, which I think it is done now. There will be small things which may stop us to perform the transactions, which we can tackle whenever we get the errors. Like for example, the number ranges and all, these are some things which may come whenever we do the transactions. So now let's focus on the main topic that I told you. The difference is the deltas in terms of the master data. What has been changed from the master data point of view? So we'll start off with the very important master data, that is of customer and vendor. So normally, as you know, that if I want to create a customer or a vendor in SAP ECC, I was using these transactions like XD01, okay, and XK01 to create a vendor. But now, as you can see, I just entered the same transaction XD01, which resulted in a error. Not an error, but it is saying that automatically system has redirected to transaction BP as transaction XT01 is obsolete. So which means XT01 is not available as it was available till now. So how are we going to create the customer? It is redirecting to transaction BP, which is for the creation of business partner, which means in SAP S/4HANA, the way in which the customer was created is not same. It has to be created now as a business partner. So whenever you want to create a customer or a vendor, it has to be created via the business partner screen. Now, what is the difference? Is business partner a new concept in SAP? Not at all, because in ECC also, there was a business partner concept. So if you were using the applications like SRM, CRM, FSCM, in those applications, we were already using the business partner master data. But the master data for CRM, SRM was different, and the master data for ECC system, which we normally do the transactions with, for example, the sales order transactions, purchasing order transactions, we normally don't worry about the business partner. We do the transactions through customers and vendors. But now in SAP S/4HANA, there is a centralized master data in the form of business partner, which means all the applications, including the SAP S4 application, CRM application, SRM, FSCM, whatever different components are there, the master data will be created only via transaction business partner, that is BP. Okay, why that is required? Because as I told you, currently CRM, SRM applications are still available as the separate applications with SAP S4. But going forward, maybe 1 year, 2 year down the line, CRM, SRM, APO, all these things, even EWM, all these things are going to be within. They are going to be embedded within the same system, that is SAP S/4HANA system. So in preparation to that, we are not going to create a separate master data for independent applications. We need a centralized master data for all the applications at one place. And that is the reason business partner approach has been selected as an approach for creation of the customers and vendors. All right. That is the reason you are getting this error here, that the way in which you were creating the customers is not available now. It has to be created via the transaction business partner. And system is automatically redirecting you to this new transaction. Okay, so what it is saying is automatically the transaction BP is called and system is asking you to create a business partner, and it is giving you these three options. Whether you want to create a business partner as a person or as an organization or as a group. Okay, so let me tell you what exactly is the difference. And normally for our purpose, we are always going to use the organization, but let me just give you the overview of what these three things are. So for example, let's take a example of Tata Group. Okay, within Tata Group, there are many different company codes. So this is nothing but a group. Within Tata Group, there are a lot of Tata Chemicals, Tata Steel. All these are different organizations, right? TCS, these are all different organizations. And within these companies, there are different persons who are working. So let's say A is a person, B is a person, just for example. So these are the persons. So what I can do is, I can either create a business partner as a group, or I can create the business partner as an organization, or I can create a business partner as a particular person. But normally, when we are talking about creation of customer and vendor, we'll be always creating the organizations. Okay, another example, let's say you are dealing with a bank, let's say HSBC Bank. So HSBC Bank will be the group because there are different branches. So HSBC, let's say for example, HSBC India is one branch, HSBC, let's say China is another branch. Okay, so this will be treated as an organization, and the bank representative, who is representative for us in terms of doing the transactions, it is like a person. So you can create the links between the person and organization and organization and group. Okay, but this is just for the explanation purpose, but otherwise we are always going to click on the second option, that is the organization. Okay, once you click on it, just go to continue. It will take you to the completely new screen of business partner. So this is saying you create the organization under the role FI customer. Okay, I'll tell you why exactly it is taking me to this particular role, but let me tell you first what are this screen all about. So in this screen, system is not asking you the customer information. Normally, let me just open the ECC screen also, so that we are able to compare the two screens. Okay, so normally if you open XD01 here, system asks you the customer account group and the company code where you want to create a customer. Even if you want to provide the sales organization, that also you can enter in this screen. But here, as you can see, it is not asking you any customer group. Okay, what it is asking is, instead of customer number, it is asking you business partner number. And instead of customer account group, it is asking you business partner grouping. Okay, so what exactly is this? Let me just go for creation of business partner. Let me select any particular grouping. I'm going for 0001, which is internal number assignment. So I don't need to provide this business partner number because it will be taken by this grouping. Create in business partner role, there are different roles under which a particular business partner can be created. Business partner means any stakeholder which is dealing with your business. It can be your vendor, it can be your customer, it can be external company, it can be the sponsor, it can be the agency. You can see there are a lot of different roles which a particular stakeholder can play in your organization. Okay, but we don't need to worry about all this. We are bothered about hardly 5 or 6 roles out of it. Out of that, more importantly, for customers, we have two, FLCU00 and FLCU01. And for vendor, we have FLVN00 and FLVN01. What is the difference? We'll see. So first of all, if I just go for, instead of this role, creating VP role FI customer, I can go with the general role, which is a business partner general role. Okay, system is asking you, do you want to create a business partner in VP with this role? I'll say yes, create. So it will ask me for this information. I'll just provide this information. So this is company. I need to provide the, let's say, test customer or test business partner. Okay, for SL20, which will help us to identify our customers and vendors. Okay, other important things, if you find anything mandatory, we will enter, otherwise we'll just keep it blank as of now. Okay, so the basic information I provided, now let me try to save, whether it is allowing me to save or not. It is saying address is incomplete, so mandatory information is country, I think. Let's click on save now. So now the business partner has been created with this number, 5021. So does it mean the customer is created? No, only the business partner is created. If the customer is also created, I can go into this role and find out whether FLCU00 or FLCU01. If there is a role created under the business partner for customer, then yes, definitely the customer is created. But as of now, as you can see, there are only two roles, which are the default roles for this business partner, are created, which means still the customer is not created. Now the question is, how this number got generated, 5021? So as I told you, based on the business partner grouping, we selected the grouping 0001, which is assigned to the number range, based on which this number got generated.